Welcome back to this week's episode of Why Iowa. And as Memorial Day weekend is approaching, today we're going to tell you the story of an Iowa icon, John J.T. Tomlinson. Truly a role model to which we can aspire and is a visual of what can be accomplished.
Here in the heartland, this is the working man. These are the fields of dreams of American. No, you can't take that away, 'cause I wanna stay here in the heartland.
In northeast Iowa, on the confluence of the Winnebago and the Shell Rock River, sits the town of Rockford, Iowa. A community consisting of nearly 900 residents was built on a foundation of agriculture and clay mining. The students attend Rudd Rockford Marble Rock Community School District, and their school nickname is the Warriors. And one of our greatest warriors was forged out of this community, John J.T. Tomlinson. An energetic and adventurous boy who enjoyed the outdoors, he was a good student and enjoyed the social aspect of school. His mother wanted to encourage him to read more, so she told him to pick out any book that he would read and she would buy it. John would pick out Richard Marcinko's Rogue Warrior. And at the age of 15, his path was set to become a U.S. Navy SEAL. An early passion in wrestling and taekwondo was a springboard for his future. In high school, he was a multi-sport athlete, competing in football, wrestling, and track. Later in high school, he'd even get involved in competing in marathons and triathlons. As a senior, he was voted homecoming king. And prior to entering his senior year, he enlisted in the Navy. So upon graduation, he was headed off to basic training. After 6 years in the Navy, JT was accepted into SEAL training program and then entered Bud's training in Coronado, which would culminate with the infamous Hell Week. 5.5 days of constant training with no more than 4 hours of sleep. On April 12th of 2002, his goal became a reality, and JT earned his SEAL Trident. He would work his way up through the teams until he eventually reached the pinnacle, becoming a member of SEAL Team 6. JT served in a variety of roles within the SEAL teams, with multiple deployments overseas and with numerous accounts of valor. On August 6th of 2011, JT was part of a quick reaction force who answered the call to assist a Ranger unit in the rugged terrain of Afghanistan. Their Chinook helicopter, call sign Extortion 17, was shot down with all 38 people on board perishing. JT, along with the other 29 Americans on board, made the ultimate sacrifice. Throughout his journey, Rockford, Iowa was always home, and he would return often. Running had become both a passion and a necessity to meet the demands of his occupation. Numerous residents would speak of seeing JT out running as they headed about their daily routine, whether it was on the track at the local high school or whether it was the open roads around Rockford, Iowa. And they would return hours later, they would see JT still out running. He was driven by a focus and a determination, and yet he was also caring to all those around him. Today at the Rockford Fossil Quarry, JT and his beloved dog Hawkeye are carved in motion, overlooking the community that he loved. JT embodied the values that we treasure most as Iowans: toughness and grit, with grace and class. This Memorial Day weekend, honor JT and all those who have served by echoing the words that Chaplain Bradshaw spoke at his memorial service. Crush your excuses. Set your goals high, serve others, and go crush it, just as John J.T. Tomlinson lived his life.
As a reminder to all of our Iowa visitors, thanks to our partner Musco Lighting, all Iowa students receive free admission to the Iowa Hall of Pride.
For me to be a role model, it is a little uncomfortable. It's a little unnerving. It makes me try the best every single day of my life because I know what's at stake. I know what I'm representing, and I know the people that are looking up to me, and it's now up to me, which puts a lot of responsibility. Everyone's responsible for themselves, but if people look up to you, it's a little bit something extra, and that's not necessarily the most calming, soothing feeling in the world, but it's an important thing, and someone has to do it, and if it's me, as long as I'm going out there and giving 110%, then I won't be comfortable with it, but I'll be okay with it.
Okay,
Be sure and follow the Iowa Hall of Pride Facebook to learn more about the annual 5K fun run in Rockford, Iowa, honoring John J.T. Tomlinson. The Go Crush It Run, the Hall of Pride will be posting updates as the event gets closer.